Hello friends, welcome to Knowledge Village once again, and in today's tutorial we will take a look at some of the important mathematical functions in Excel. So let us jump straight in. On the screen I have some data, and with the help of this data we will see how some of the functions operate in Excel. The first function which we will look at is the sum function, which most of you already know. The sum function starts with a is equal to and sum, sum. So we sum, and we can select a range to sum like this and close the range and hit an enter. So we get the answer for the whole range. Otherwise we can also sum by selecting individual items. Like for example, we start the sum function and I select this item which I want to sum. Then I put a comma and then I select the second option, second number which I want to include in my summation. Then I put a comma, then I include the third number which I want to use in my summation. So we can go like this on and on. Once we finish, we close the formula with the help of the closing bracket and hit an enter. So if you press F2, you see this is the sum of these three cells, 221. So this is how we use the sum function in Excel. Now let us look at one very important function which nobody normally uses. Over here, if you can see, if I want to find the total cost of all these products, not individually but as a sum. So what I need to do is, first of all, over here I need to sum these units with the unit cost, right? So I will multiply the unit cost and the number of units. So I will copy this down, okay, and then I can sum it. So we get 4083, but Excel provides us with a function called as sum product. And what sum product does is, it sums different arrays by multiplying the cells horizontally in those arrays. For example, instead of finding out the product of these two cells and writing it here, and these two cells and writing it here, and then taking the sum of all these things as 4083, I can use, if I just wanted to know the sum and the total cost of all these items, I can use the sum function and we can find it out without going through all these hassles. How I go about it? I will say sum product and I will open the function. Now see, it's asked us as arguments the arrays. So array 1, array 2, array 3. We can have many number of arrays. Okay. Right now in this example, what we will do is, we will select this array, we will put a comma, and then we will select this array. Okay, so what we are doing is, we are selecting two arrays, and by using this function, what Excel will do is, it will multiply horizontally the cells of these arrays corresponding to each other, and then it will give us a total sum amount. What I mean by this is, if you close this now, and hit an enter, you see we got the same 483 without actually going through all this multiplication. Okay, so this is how we use the sum product function. Okay, the third important function which I wanted to tell you about is the rand function. Now the rand function is very simple. We have to just say RAND and close bracket and open bracket. What it does is it throws out a random number. Okay, so Excel with the help of this function gives us a random number, and if you refresh this, you see another random number has been generated between 0 and 1. Between 0 and 1. So like this is we can generate multiple random numbers as and when we require under certain scenarios. So like this. So every time we refresh the formula, a new random number is generated. Okay. Now similarly, we have one more random number function by which we can generate random numbers between the numbers specified. For example, if I say random between and I open the function, and what it says is I have to write the bottom number and the top number. So the bottom number is what is the least number and what is the maximum number. For example, if I write here 1, and if in the maximum number I write 1000, comma 1000, and then I close the parenthesis and hit an enter, it gives me a random number, this time not between 0 and 1, but this time between what we have specified. And what we have specified is between 1 and 1000 over here. If you see on the formula bar over here, we have specified between 1 and 1000. So every time I refresh this formula, I will get a new random number between the number which I have specified here, between 1 and 1000. Now if I change this and I write here 5000, then see the range changes, and now it starts giving us random numbers between 1 and 5000. So I hope this random number thing is clear. Now the third function, important function which I wanted to share with you, is the round function. For example, over here we have a number mentioned in decimal places. Okay. Now if I want to round this number to just two decimal places, I can do it with the help of a random round function in Excel. And what is that? Is equal to round. And I begin the function, I select the cell or the value which I want to round, then comma and till what digit I want the round of. For example, if I want it up to 2 digits, so I write 2 and I close the bracket and I hit an enter. So see, in this case Excel has rounded this number to 2 digits. Now in case I need it for 3 digits, I can go here and write 3 digits and it will round off to 3 digits. See, 48.788. So this time what it has done is it has rounded this number from here to here to with 3 decimal places. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Now the last function which I wanted to share with you for today is the mod function. The mod function, what it does is, let us take this example again over here. For example, I have 50 and I have 45 over here. Okay, so let us take two examples for the mod function. So for example, let us take here 47. So in this case, what the mod function does is, if I start the mod function, it begins with MOD. Okay, and the argument what it takes is the number and the divisor. So what if the number would be the number which we want to divide, and the divisor is the number by which we will divide this number. Okay, so in this case we will select this 50 and let us right now divide this by 5. So 50 divided by 5, so the remainder or the mod will be 0. Why? Because entirely it goes as 10 times, 5 goes 10 times into 50. So the remainder is 0. Now if we copy this formula over here and we see that the mod is 2. Why? Because when 47 is divided by 5, it goes 9 times and the remain as 45 into this and the remainder is 2. Now in case if you change this to divided by 4, so what happens is 4 goes 11 times in as 44 into this and the remainder is 3. So this is how the mod function operates. So today we have taken a look at the sum function, the sum product function, the random number, the random between number and the mod function. These are some of the important functions in maths, in Excel. I hope that they will be useful to you in your daily work. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your near and dear ones. Thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like it and share it with others. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get notifications of new videos.